Hello everyone, hello grade 7. I am teacher Gypsy Rose O. Francisco and I am your math teacher for this week. For any clarification or question, you can ask your mathematics teacher in 7 for further explanation. For this week's most essential learning competency, the learner should classify the different kinds of angles. And our topic for this week is all about different kinds of angles. So let's define first what is an angle. An angle is a union of two non-collinear rays with common endpoint. So let's see this illustration. So we have there the two non-collinear rays with common endpoint labeled as capital letter A, so point A. And then these two non-collinear rays are what we call the sides of an angle. And this common endpoint is what we call the vertex. Please take note of the parts of an angle. So let's proceed to the next one. So in measuring an angle, we use the instrument protractor. So this protractor is usually looks like this. So ayan siya, semicircle with the degree marks. Ayan. So it was invented by Joseph Haddard. So protractor is an instrument used to measure angles. Please take note of that. And then the unit of measure we use in the degree is denoted by ayon yung degree yan. And then an angle measures are between 0 degrees to 180 degrees. Ayan, kung titingnan niyo yung protractor, ayan oh, from 0 to 180. And then the measure of angle A is denoted by pag kukunin nyo yung measure of angle A, pagsusulat yung measure, di mo na, no need to write measure, so just a small letter M, and then the symbol of angle, yung, ayan, the symbol of angle, and then the letter. Or simply, angle A, pwede rin. The measure of angle A or angle A. So we have here the three different types of angles. So the first one is acute angle. Acute angle measure more than 0 degrees but less than 90 degrees. Using the protractor, we have here an example of an acute angle. So kung titignan nyo dyan, ang measure ng angle dyan ay 30 degrees. So 30 degrees is less than 90 degrees, tama? Yung nasa gitna is 90, so less than, okay? So, tama, acute angle. So, ganyan yung itsura ng acute angle. Another. Okay, so 30 degrees. Then, next type of angle, we have the what we call right angle. Measures exactly 90 degrees, so let's see. Using the protractor again. Exactly 90 degrees. So, yung arrow na nakaturo sa 90. And then, yung degree na tinatawag natin, ito siya. So, ito, yung blue. Ayan, yan yung degree natin. So, it is 90 degrees. The measure from the longer arrow to the smaller arrow is 90 degrees. The measure of angle based from the protractor. How about the third one? Obtuse angle. Okay, measures more than 90 degrees but less than 180 degrees. Based from the protractor, we have there, okay. So, yung isang, the shorter arrow, lumagpas na siya sa 90 degrees. Ayan. Pero, less than 180 siya. Yan, yung size nun, 120 degrees. Okay? Yung size ng arrow na blue, yun yung degree natin. The measure of the degree is 120 degrees. Again, what are those three types of angles? We have the acute angle, right angle, and obtuse angle. We also have the what we call perpendicular lines. When we see perpendicular lines, if two lines or segments intersect so that they form a right angle. So, what's the measure of a right angle? It is 90 degrees. In fact, two perpendicular lines meet to form four right angles. Tama. Tama naman. This is an example of a perpendicular line with the symbol of a right angle. Ayan. Kung makikita nyo na yan, right angle na yan. So, are we clear with the perpendicular lines? So, that's it for today. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for the next virtual instruction. Thank you!